in the microscopic view of resistance, how it is influenced by the temperature. Meanwhile, right, resistance is inversely proportional to the relaxation time. Already we know that what is the relaxation time. When the electric field is applied on a conductor, then electrons are going to be accelerated. Electrons are going to be accelerated in the opposite direction of electric field. Whenever the electrons are accelerated, they go on colliding with the ionic lattice of the conductors. In each collision, electrons will lose the energy. Therefore, in such a case, electrons go on colliding with the ionic lattice. Therefore, there are successive collisions may faced by the electrons. The time interval between two successive collisions of the electrons is called relaxation time. Therefore, resistance of a conductor is inversely proportional to the relaxation time. This is called microscopic view. What is the macroscopic view? Let us consider this is the conductor. This is the conductor. Right? Right here in this case, what is the length of the conductor? L. What is the cross-sectional area of the conductor? A. What is the resistivity of the conductor? Rho. Now, what is the resistance of the conductor? R1. It is at a temperature T1. Now, on heating, what is the resistance? R2. What is the temperature? T2. Therefore, there is a conductor of resistance R1, which is at a temperature T2. Now, the temperature is increased from T1 to T2. Now, here in this case, now, change in resistance R2 minus R1 is directly proportional to the initial resistance. Change in resistance is directly proportional to the initial resistance. Experimentally, we came to know that on heating the conductor, resistance is changed. On heating the conductor, temperature is also changed. Therefore, initial resistance is R1, final resistance is R2. Change in resistance is R2 minus R1. This change in resistance depends upon the initial resistance, and this change in resistance is again directly proportional to the temperature difference T2 minus T1. Right? Therefore, on combining both, R2 minus R1 is directly proportional to R1 into, what to say, T2 minus T1. Therefore, this is called, what to say, proportionality symbol. Now, this proportionality R1 minus R2, this proportionality is coming to equals to, there is a proportionality constant alpha. This is a symbol for proportionality, right? This is the symbol of alpha. Now, thus the proportionality is coming to equals to, there is a proportionality constant alpha into, that is R1 into T2 minus T1. Right? Now, here in this case, that is R2 minus R1, where alpha is a proportionality constant. This is also known as temperature coefficient of resistance. Now, here in this case, R2 is equals to, on shifting right side, R1 plus alpha into R1 into T2 minus T1. Therefore, R2 minus R1 is equals to, R2 is equals to R1 into 1 plus alpha, that is T2 minus T1. Therefore, here R2 is equals to R1 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. Therefore, for a conductor, there is a temperature coefficient of resistance alpha. Then at the initial temperature T1, the resistance is represented by R1. At the final temperature, that is T2, the resistance is represented by R2. Then the final resistance value R2 is equals to, what do you say, R1 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. Therefore, from this definition, right, from this definition, therefore alpha is equals to, what do you say, alpha is equals to, that is R2 minus R1 by R1 into, that is T2 minus T1. This may be written as alpha is equals to R2 minus R1, that is called change in resistance, by initial resistance into T2 minus T1 is equals to delta T. Therefore, this is also formula for alpha. What is alpha? Temperature coefficient of resistance. Alpha is equals to, right, delta R by R into delta T. Suppose here temperature is increased. Suppose temperature is increased. Now resistance is also increased, then alpha value is positive. Sometimes temperature is increased, right? Resistance is decreased, then alpha is equals to negative. Therefore, here to understand the variation of resistance with respect to the temperature can be explained through a quantity. That quantity is called temperature coefficient of resistance. Now, on experimental observations, the change in resistance is directly proportional to the initial resistance. The change in resistance is directly proportional to the change in absolute temperatures. On combining both, R2 minus R1 is equals to alpha into, that is R1 into T2 minus T1, right? From this equation, alpha is equals to R2 minus R1 by R1 into T2 minus T1. Therefore, R2 minus R1, change in resistance is represented by delta R. Initial resistance is represented by R. T2 minus T1 is represented by delta T. Therefore, alpha is equals to R2. Alpha is equals to delta R by R into delta T. From this equation, as the temperature is increased, sometimes resistance is increased. Whenever the temperature is increased, then resistance also increased, the temperature coefficient of resistance is positive. Temperature is increased, but the resistance is decreased, then temperature coefficient of resistance is negative. Now, what is the definition of alpha? What is the definition of alpha? Now, here in this case, delta T is equals to 1. Delta T is equals to 1. That is, alpha is equals to, what to say, delta R by R. Delta R by R, that is change in resistance. Change in resistance by, what to say, initial resistance. Right? Initial resistance. Right, now change in resistance by initial resistance is called fraction of change in resistance. Fraction of change in resistance. Therefore, now the fraction of change in resistance per unit rise in temperature of the conductor is called the temperature coefficient of resistance. Let us consider a conductor. Temperature is increased by 1 in absolute, 300 Kelvin to 301 Kelvin, or 500 Kelvin to 501 Kelvin, or 167 Kelvin to 168 Kelvin. What is the change in temperature? 1. Whenever the conductor temperature is increased by 1 Kelvin or unit temperature, there is a fraction of change in resistance. Fraction of change in resistance means change in resistance by initial resistance. Change in resistance by initial resistance is also known as fraction of change in resistance. Therefore, the fraction of change in resistance per unit rise in temperature is called temperature coefficient of resistance. Now, what is the unit of that is temperature coefficient of resistance. Now alpha is equals to change in resistance unit is ohm by R. Resistance is also ohm. Now delta T, temperature difference unit is Kelvin. Ohm gets cancelled. Alpha is equals to K to the power of minus 1 per Kelvin, or otherwise per degree centigrade, or per degree Fahrenheit, or per Kelvin is the unit of temperature coefficient of resistance. Therefore, from this formula, that is R2 is equals to R1 into 1 plus R1 plus alpha into, that is what to say, T2 minus T1. From this case, if at T1 is equals to 0 degree centigrade, let us consider. Now, what is the resistance? R1 is equals to R0. Now, temperature is increased to T2, that equals to T degree centigrade. Now R2 is equals to, what to say, that is RT. The resistance is represented by RT. Now here R2, let us consider there is a conductor. Conductor temperature is increased from 0 degree centigrade to T degree centigrade. Now the resistance is changed from R0 to RT. Therefore R2 is equals to, what to say, that is R2 is equals to RT is equals to R1 is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha into T2 minus T1. T minus 0. Therefore, RT is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha into T. Therefore, this is the variation of resistance with respect to the temperature. There is a formula, there is also a formula. If the initial temperature at 0 degree centigrade is R0, now at the final temperature T degree centigrade RT, therefore RT is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha into T1. Suppose temperature is increased from right 0 degree centigrade to T degree centigrade. Therefore R1 is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha into T1. Therefore R2 is equals to, that is temperature is increased from 0 degree centigrade to T2 degree centigrade. Therefore R2 is equals to, what to say, that is R0 into, what to say, alpha into T2. Therefore here RT is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha into T. Now the conductor is there. Conductor temperature is increased from 0 degree centigrade to T1 degree centigrade. This is called initial temperature. This is called final temperature. Therefore R1 is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha into T. Therefore in the second case, I am increasing the temperature from 0 degree centigrade to T2 degree centigrade. R2 is equals to R0 into 1 plus alpha into T2. Therefore this is called first equation and this is called second equation.